Hello, everybody, and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and it is time for some NHL 14 action. Yep, it is time to create our Live the Life character. This year, I wanted to play with the new Enforcer engine, and when I thought about that and thought about creating an Enforcer, my mind immediately went back to my younger days, my early teenage days, and watching Mr. Basil McRae for the North Stars not backing down from anybody. He and Shane Chirlo would get into great fights there. They were affectionately known by the North Stars fans as Bump and Thump, so I'm recreating Basil McRae. I want to take this on here as the Enforcer role. I'm going to put him in to the entry draft level. So I'm going to place him on a junior team to start with so he can get drafted, and that will be the London Knights. That's who he played for in real life, so why not put him there? So recreating Basil McRae, my favorite player growing up to watch. This is going to be a lot of fun, guys. Here's a few of the things that are new to be a pro, talking about the likability meters. You can pause those and read those if you want. I'm not going to read paragraphs here, but you can definitely look. They're also talking about the interviews that we'll encounter that will sculpt the play as we go here. So that's why it's called Live the Life. It's got new elements to it that are kind of role-playing elements, and we'll go through those as we go, dealing with media, dealing with teammates, dealing with management, dealing with fans. All these things are going to factor in. So it is time for Baz to hit the ice for the first time. Now, he wears number 17 in real life, or wore number 17 in real life, but 17 is taken on the London Knights right now, so he'll have to settle for number 19. Hopefully we can change that when we get to the NHL level and get him that customary number 17. But we're not going to worry about that for right now. Our job is to go out there, stir things up, get some big hits, and get things going here. Protect teammates. Here he's already jostling here behind the net a little bit. Is this guy going to want to go? No, he's not going to drop the gloves. Maybe later in the game. So we're midway through the second period, and boom! Oh, what a big hit here. And that player is down, and he is not getting up. Basil just ran right through him. Let's watch the replay, and just like a truck, goes right through him, upends him. He is going to need assistance getting off the ice. That's the kind of presence we want to have out on the ice. Now look at this, you got two players in a skirmish, but he's going to get in here and say, ah, this is my role. I'm going to take on a fight. Let's do this. Oh, he takes an uppercut, and he's taking a couple shots early here. Maybe he can rebound in this fight. Let's see. Takes another shot. He's got to get himself going. Going to try to lean into it. Here we go. Now he's getting some punches back and forth. We're going, and he's going to end up winning this scrap. Nice job right there. His first fight, at least since we've taken over his career. So Basil McRae wins fight number one, and that's got to be a good feeling here as he is producing in his role of enforcer for this London Knights squad, and hopefully the NHL is taking notice. So you notice I gave him a permanent black eye there. I figured that would be appropriate. So back out on the ice, and what are we doing? We're looking for a big hit. I wasn't even controlling him then, and he takes a penalty. Yeah, he had gotten back on the ice, but I still had not gotten control of him. And look at what he does. He goes out and gets himself a game misconduct for charging. He's not happy. His teammates win in overtime, so they get the victory without him. But man, oh man, I got tossed from the game when I wasn't even controlling Basil out there. So that's not cool, other than the fact that he lived up to his reputation of the hard hits and everything. So we get some XP there, which was actually ahead of schedule with what they wanted to see me get, so I guess I'm happy with that. So we go back out on the ice now for game number two, and you look at the coach's goal, pressure the D-man and sustain a good hard forecheck tonight. That's exactly what we're going to try to do here, and right here he is going to get some of the points there. You see that little icon with the whistle pop up every time they get a hit. Now we've got another player down. Another opponent is writhing in pain. DeLeo is not getting up. Let's see what happened here. It was a team effort. It was more of his teammate that got a good shot on him, but I think Basil McRae finished up on him as well, and it was more of a sandwich effect. They send him off. There you see more good forechecking, and that's showing up in his rating there, with the little icon showing up where he's getting closer to his goal. Here he's fighting to get the puck, and he's going to go right to the net with it. Backhander's not going to go, and he's a little frustrated he couldn't get it in the net, so he's going to take that out on the nearest player who wants to scrap with him. Is it go time? Oh, let's give him the face wash. Yep, he'll go now. Here we go. Let's drop the gloves. I love the new Enforcer engine. Some of you might say the fights happen too often. Yeah, I probably agree with that too, but when I'm going to be an Enforcer, I'm pretty cool with this. I love the new engine. I love how things work. Basil wins another fight here. I just think this is, it may not be perfect, but this is a huge improvement over what fighting was in the game for really the last, you know, I don't know, forever, really. I was going to say like the last four or five versions of this game. But, I mean, as for as long as I can remember, the fighting just really left a lot to be desired. Either you were brought into a cutscene that just kind of took you away from the game. Now it feels like it's part of the game. You can jump in. Oh, speaking of jumping in, here we go again. He wants to scrum one more time. Well, let's see how this is going to go. Come on, Basil. Get those punches. I've been working on trying to get the uppercut a little bit more. I don't use it nearly enough. Right there, he just goes with some headshots and takes him down. But yeah, I'm working on that uppercut and trying not to lose when I throw those. But I got to time them well. So that'll be something I'll get better at as I go. But here he's like, yeah, let's just get this going again. So once again, another fight for Baz. And this game is just about in the books as they go to the box. They do drop the game 4-2. So that's a rough one. They could not win it. So we go back into the coach's office, and again, he did pretty decent with his XP and his draft projection between 47th and 75th if it were to happen now. So let's go up the XP attribute totals here in the different categories, get Basil McRae going here with some things he could use. Definitely body checking is one of them, and you want him to have strength, you want him to have endurance, balance, all those good things, durability. So all the categories that'll help him in his role of enforcer here and looking to make an NHL squad. So let's get back out of the ice for one more game in this episode here, and we'll see how things are going against Halifax. As we have a scoreless game in the first, again, throwing the body around. The goal was to get out there and throw some checks. Wasn't really about the forechecking this time. It was just laying the body out. Oh, he might have been a little too aggressive there as he gets an interference call. Yeah, he'll have to go sit down for 2 minutes for that one. When he gets back out of the box, he's looking to let up a big hit. And oh my goodness, he just destroyed that guy as well. Looking to throw that body around whenever possible. Does it again right there. As you see, he is getting the coach to take notice. And oh, he just missed a goal there. And follows up by a crunching hit. He hit the crossbar. He doesn't care. He goes and levels his guy. And then almost centered that pass for an assist there. Couldn't quite get it. Looking to pass to a teammate. And looking to cause trouble in front of the net. Oh, you know when the whistle blows. What's he looking for? He's looking to face off. He's going to take on Duke this time. He says, come on, let's get this going. Get over here. So eventually, this one, they actually stay away from each other for a while. He takes a pop, and now they finally get in close range. Can Basil win this? Oh, he pops the helmet right off, and he is on the offensive. Did I get an uppercut in there? I don't know. I might have had one. He takes him down. Basil McRae wins again, and he is quite pumped up about it. Let's look at this. Yes, sir. He's getting that crowd going. Look at that. So still a scoreless game in the second. Trying to get a shot on net. And that rebound there. Wow, the goalie shouldn't have let that one down because it goes in. But it is London's only goal on the day. They lose 4-1. So the first three games are done. Now we wait, it says. And you can read the note from the coaches, but that is going to do it for episode one. Come on back here as Basil McRae continues the life of the enforcer and looking to get drafted in the NHL. Next, we'll see you then.